Tone painting or word painting can roughly be defined as the act of expressing meanings or connotations associated with a word or phrase in a text through the music that it is set to. This might be achieved through means harmonic, rhythmic, pertaining to the shape of the melodic line, or any other musical technique the composer chooses. Tone painting is most closely associated with the Renaissance madrigalists, but examples abound in the works of later composers. Some instances of the technique are readily understood. Let's take a look at a couple of these. In Thomas Weelkes' madrigal, As Vesta Was from Latmos Hill Descending, the voices sing rising melodic figures for the word Latmos Hill, and falling ones for the word descending. Another example is the use of drawn-out, unsettling dissonances on the word dolorosi, meaning painful, in Carlo Gesualdo's madrigal, Io Parto. Some examples are less intuitive. You may be wondering what J.S. Bach's chorale prelude, Die Sinn die Heiligen Zahn geworden, These are the Holy Ten Commandments, is doing in a video about word painting, given that it's a piece for solo organ. It is based on a chorale by Bach, which in turn is based on a hymn by Martin Luther, whose lyrics speak about the Ten Commandments. In the chorale prelude, Bach makes use of a canon. No, Tchaikovsky, not that type of canon. A canon is a musical technique in which one voice strictly follows another after an elapse of time. Think of Frère Jacques or Row, Row, Row Your Boat. It is so called because canon means rule or precept in Latin. When one knows this, the relationship between the compositional technique and the word commandment becomes clear. The effect of this is perhaps not local enough to conform to a strict definition of tone painting, but it is a stunningly creative example of a composer using the words of a text to inspire the music, which is in essence what tone painting is about. I recommend that you look into this fascinating piece, as I haven't even scratched the surface of what's going on with it here. Tone painting found particular favour amongst the composers of the 19th century German Lied. Schubert was particularly adept at the technique, and his use of it often intersected with his characteristic interplay between major and minor modes. Let's take a quick look at the final verse of Einsamkeit from his Winterreise song cycle. First, note the forte dynamic and the stormy tremolo in the left hand gently subsiding on the word ruhig, meaning calm, in the line, Ach, dass die Luft so ruhig, alas, the air is so calm. Ach, dass die Luft so ruhig. More generally, Moore's words seem to conjure up a resigned world-weariness resulting from the protagonist's hopes being repeatedly dashed. The way Schubert conveys this through harmony is nothing short of breathtaking. He first elicits a sense of hope by using a Neapolitan 6-4, as if it were a cadential 6-4, leading the listener to expect a cadence in the relatively bright key of C major. The dominant 7th is then reinterpreted as its enharmonic, a German augmented 6th chord in the key of B minor, and we realise that the idea of going to sunny C major was nothing more than an illusion, as we are dragged inevitably back to the gloomy home key of B minor. Als noch die Stimmen tobten, war ich so elend, so elend nicht. One can find many examples of tone painting in pop music as well. The lyrics of Leonard Cohen's Hallelujah contain many references to music and music theory. Fourth, fifth, minor and major are all musical terms, and the terms are mirrored in the underlying chord progression as they are sung.
It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing Hallelujah.
One reading of this song is that it is about intercourse and climax. If that's the case, then the tonicization of A minor, which follows the lines mentioned above, and the painful suspension which accompanies it, must represent some sort of post-coital depression. Now let's take a look at some of the examples drawn from our original piece, my setting of The Tree by poet Anne Hornsby. Here's the text. Instances of tone painting are highlighted. I'll quickly read it for anybody who's just listening. The tree was tall, its bark was green. Through an archway, it was seen. It seemed to hold its branches wide and welcome those who'd step inside. Our first example is as simple as they come. We use a high note on the word tall. Our next example is slightly more subtle. In music, the term chromaticism refers to the incorporation of notes outside the key signature in use. Etymologically, chromatic is derived from the Greek word for colour, hence it's being used here on the word green. According to functional harmony, the main role of a 5 or 5-7 chord is to lead to 1, the home chord of a given key. When you hear a 5-7 chord, it means something like, next stop home. You might think that you know nothing about music theory, but you understand this on an intuitive level. So much so that when I use a 5-7 here on the words, it seemed, you expect it to resolve here to the home key. But respelling this F dominant 7th chord as its enharmonic equivalent, a German augmented 6th chord in the key of A minor, allows me to tonicize an unexpected key area. It seemed that it seemed was leading us home, whereas in fact, it wasn't. There is a suspension on the word held, the suspension being a dissonance held over from one chord to the next. The word wide is sung over the widest melodic leap in the piece. The cadential six of all is a dissonant sonority used to herald an upcoming cadence. When we hear one, we know what's going to happen next. Effectively, its purpose is to welcome the approaching cadence. On the word step, the melody is on scale degree 2. That is to say that it is what we call in music theory a step above where we expect it to be at this point. The reason that it's a step above where we expect it to be at this point is that I finished the piece with what is referred to as a feminine cadence, when the bass note moves to 1 from a 5 or 5-7 chord, but the resolution of the other chord tones is delayed slightly. I chose this because, well, actually, perhaps I won't go into too much detail as to why I chose a feminine cadence for the word inside.
Bit of blue foot dance, bit of blue. He's blue, Alan. He's blue, he's going to be good, he's blue.
Here's the piece in full.